Hello everyone, I am Shine and you are watching Civil Engineering Tips channel. This is the 15th tutorial of StatPro. In this tutorial, we are going to discuss about live load. So let's talk about it. Live load is also known as imposed load. This is the load developed by use or occupancy of the structure. In last tutorial, we learned how to apply dead load to our structure. Similarly, we will define and assign live load to our structure. To do that, we have to first create the live load folder as we created the dead load folder. To do that, we have to select the load cases details option. I'm clicking on it. Then I will go for add option, as the first folder was named as dead load and it is the second one, that's why the number is 2 here. And I will change the loading type from this option. Here I am choosing the live option and I will give a title of live load as LL. Then I will click on this add option. As I click on this add option, our live load folder has been created under the dead load folder. So we are done and I am closing it. Now let's define some live load in this folder. I am selecting this folder, then I will go for add option. Live load is assigned in the form of a floor load defined as a pressure intensity with a magnitude based on BNBC code. It depends on your country. You have to input the load intensity which is approved by your country and region. I am from Bangladesh and I am following BNBC code. To input the floor load intensity, I have to go this floor load option. I am clicking on it. Here I have to input the pressure intensity of live load. I will input two types of live load in this structure. There will be one type of live load for these two floors and another live load for this roof floor. Though we have to specify different live loads for different rooms like toilet, dining, bedroom, there will be different live loads and you have to input those live loads from BNBC code. For first floor and second floor, I am inputting here 2.87 kilonewton per meter square. And now I have to specify the range of these two floors. The minimum Y range will work in this node. So we have to know the coordinate of this node. For that, I have to make the cursor as node cursor first. Then I will select this node first. Then I will double click on this. And here I can see that here the coordinate of Y is 2, which is minimum in this case. So I am closing it and inputting the minimum Y range as 2 and the minimum X and Z range for that node is 0. So I'm keeping this minimum X and Z range as it is. For maximum range, I have to know the coordinate of this node. For that, I will select this node like that and I will double click on it. Here the coordinate is 8, 5 and 8. So I'm closing it and giving the X coordinate as 8, Y coordinate as 5 and Z coordinate as 8. Then we are done and I will go for add option. I'm clicking on this add option. As I click on this add option, my live load has been defined here and it is assigned at the same time. The floor load is automatically assigned once the range is specified. Again, I will define another live load for my roof, which is 1.435 kilonewton per meter square. So I am inputting here 1.435 kilonewton per meter square and I have to specify the range. Now for that, I will select this node and double click on it, and here the coordinate is 0, 8 and 0. I am closing it and inputting here 8, 0 and 0. For maximum range, I have to select this node first, then I will double click on it and here it is 888. So I'm closing it and I will give 8, 8 and 8. Then I will add and close. My live loads has been assigned already. If I select my live load, then I can see that this live load has been assigned for first floor and second floor. Again, if I select this one, then I can see this has been assigned for the roof. So this is how we define and assign live load to our structure. And this is all for today. If you have any question or if you face any trouble, then please comment below, or you can use the email address that I have given to description. Till then, happy learning, keep practicing. See you in the next video.